In this tutorial, we will be using a Google Earth Engine script designed to automatically detect changes that occur to areas in and around archaeological sites. Automatic change detection will be abbreviated to ACD for the rest of this tutorial. As well as using Google Earth Engine for simple things, such as creating color composites of satellite imagery or calculating and exporting NDVI data, it can also be used to carry out much more complex tasks, such as automatic change detection, or ACD. The script we will be using has been developed by the Eomina project to automatically detect change to areas surrounding archaeological sites. This will help to monitor sites and rapidly identify disturbances and threats. It works by creating one earlier and one later Sentinel-2 composite and then mathematically comparing each band, highlighting areas where there are significant differences, and then checking which archaeological sites might be threatened. Open the first version of the script. There is a link in the video description. This version of the script is set up to run ACD on a dataset of 50 sites southeast of Madaba in Jordan from the Eomina database. We are going to use this example dataset to familiarize ourselves with some of its components and outputs. Turn on the geometry in the Geometry Imports panel. This is the area that we will be looking at. Turn off the geometry, and in the Layers panel, turn off all the layers except all sites. These green polygons are the 50 sites we will be running the script with. Turn off all sites and turn on S2 imagery earlier. This is the earlier Sentinel-2 composite that we will be using. Lines 12 to 15 and lines 24 and 25 control the date of this earlier image. As you can see, the year is 2017, the month is September, and the day is the 1st. On line 24, we can see it's set to -3 and month, which means that this earlier composite is derived from data from September in 2017 and 3 months earlier than this. Turn on S2 imagery later. This is the later image. The date of this image is controlled in a similar way, from lines 5 to 8 and line 21. This is set to September 2018 and the 3 months prior to this date. So we are basically comparing a composite from the summer of 2017 and the summer of 2018. See if you can spot any differences between the two images. For example, you can see that the water levels in this lake are slightly higher in the later image. Turn off both Sentinel-2 images and turn on the change layer. These green shapes show the areas of the two images that mathematically show a significant difference up to a certain threshold that we can set in the script. However, if you turn on the satellite background and zoom, you will notice that many of them relate to agriculture, fields that maybe had crops in 2018 but not 2017, or vice versa. This might be hiding other more significant types of change, such as building, mining, or bulldozing, so we want to remove these areas as much as possible. In the Layers panel, turn on the Change No Agriculture layer. You will notice that the red Change No Agricultural layer ignores some of the more obvious green fields. We have used NDVI to remove a lot of these fields. So it is this red change no agriculture layer that we will use to compare to the archaeological site distribution. In the layers panel, turn off the two change layers and turn on all sites. These are the 50 sites that we are going to check for any changes using ACD. Turn on the change no agriculture layer and the change no agriculture sites. Whenever any of these red change areas falls within one of the sites, it gets highlighted in yellow and saved as a new layer. So these are the yellow polygons. Have a look at the console and expand the two feature collections. You should notice that in the All Sites layer, there are 50 sites, but in the Change No Agriculture Sites layer, there are only 16 sites. This is because only 16 of the 50 overlapped with the red Change No Agriculture layer, the areas of change that we detected with the ACD script. Now that you understand a little bit of how the site works, in the next videos, we are going to be using and validating this data.